this is the final step in calculating the back propagation. The last and the final step in this is that we need to compute the new weights after the back propagation is performed. We were given the weights of the forward propagation in the question. As you can see, these were the weights that were given to us, and now we have to calculate the new weights that are found by moving in the backward direction. So we are going to do it. This is a very simple. This is an equation to find to compute the new weight. Del W is equals to, this is the learning rate. This is given to us in the question. In this case, that was 1, right? Del sigma j, but we found out in our previous video, as you can see here, and yi is the values of y. Wherever comes I and j, we can see that whatever comes in the first position is always I, and whatever comes in the second position is always j. When we perform this question, you will be more clear. Now we are calculating all the values, all the weights, sorry. So let's start. Del W 4, 5. This was the first one. So we are going to this, and then sigma j is what? It is 5. And y is I, so this is 4. Right? So this was 1. Del 5 was 0.04. So -0.04 multiplied by y4 was 0.66. From where this y4 comes from, this was we done in the first step. This is y3. In the first step, right? This is y4 we are using, and then for the same case y5 we will use this one. Okay, also multiplying this -0.0264. Now we have to calculate del W 4 5 new. So we will add del W 4 5 old with simple del W 4 5. What was del W 4 5? 5 was given in our question. This 4 5 into 0.9. So we will multiply 0.9. Sorry, we will add 0.9 plus with this -0.0264. So upon doing this calculations, we get the result for 0.873. Del W 4 5 is 0.873. We are going to write del W 4 5 for the 0.873. This is the new weight after doing the back propagation. Same is the case we will do for 3, 5, 1, 3, 2, 3, 1, 4, and for all. I'm going to do it now.